हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय अनदर वीडियो ऑन द सीरीज ऑफ ऑन द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट डिस्क्रीट मैथमेटिकल स्ट्रक्चर. एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज प्रिंसिपल कंजंक्टिव नॉर्मल फॉर्म. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर, इन माय लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट प्रिंसिपल डिसजंक्टिव नॉर्मल फॉर्म. एंड टुडे दिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ शॉर्ट लेक्चर ऑफ अबाउट 10 मिनट्स. And today we are going to discuss about principal conjunctive normal form. In short, this is represented as PDNF. So it is PCNF, or it is also called as product of sum. So POS. So we are going to discuss all that concepts in the next slides. So let us move ahead and let us try to know what is this principal conjunctive normal form. So in my previous lecture we have discussed about some of the terms, and that terms are called as mean terms. So what is a mean term? It is product of the variables. So for example, let us say if this is one mean term, okay, then these mean terms are disjuncted together to form a principal disjunctive normal form. So now here we are in this particular lecture, we are going to deal with some of the concepts, and the term that we are going to discuss here is max term. So let us try to know about what is a max term. So for a given number of variables, the max term consists of disjunctions in which each variable or its negation, in which there is a variable is there or its negation is there, but not both. That is, for a variable p, the presence of disjunction of not p, p disjuncted not p, this will not be allowed. It will have the combination of all the variables. For example, if there are three variables, so all the three occurrences of all the variables will be there, and they will be joined together by using a disjunction. They are going to be joined by using a disjunction. Okay. Now here the terms are going to be these disjunction, these sum are going to be joined by using AND. So this is called as product of sum. Hence this is called as product of sum. So thus the max term are duals of min term. So this one we have already discussed. So whenever there is a equation p and q and r, then its dual will be p or q or r. So these max terms, this shows that these max term are the duals of the min terms. Further, either from the duality principle or directly from the truth table, it can be ascertained that each of the max term has the truth value false. It has the truth value false for exactly one combination of the truth value of the variables. In the min terms, what we have done is we have considered all the min terms in which the outcome is true. Whereas here in the max term, we are going to consider all the max terms where the output is false. Okay. You can go to my previous video lecture and you can check over there that we have in the min terms we have considered all the truth value, all the min terms whose truth value is true, whereas here we are going to consider all the max terms whose truth value is false. So different max terms have truth value false for different combinations of the truth values of the variables. There can be multiple occurrences of the max terms where the truth value is false. Let us try to understand this principal conjunctive normal form in more better way. So for a given formula, an equivalent formula consisting of conjunction of the max terms. So max term, this is one max term. So for two variable formula, this is one max term. Another max term can be P or not Q. Another max term will be not P or Q. So there will be four max term possible, not P or not Q. So these are the disjunctions, and conjunction of these disjunction is called as principal conjunctive normal form. This is also called as product of sum, canonical form. Each formula which is not a tautology. Now this can be obtained for every formula which is not a tautology. In my last video lecture, the principal disjunctive normal form can be obtained for the formula which is not contradiction. Whereas it is reverse here. I can identify a conjunctive normal form, principal conjunctive normal form, for any formula which is not a tautology. So for each formula which is not a tautology has equivalent PCNF, that is principal conjunctive normal form, which is unique. This is going to be unique, and PDNF was also unique in the, you can go and check in my last video lecture, except for the rearrangement of the factors. We have to make some rearrangement into the factors and every principal conjunction normal form will be unique. Let us move ahead and let us try to solve one example of PCNF. So obtain the PCNF of S. Suppose this is a formula S. S is equal to not P implies R and Q biconditional P. So first what we have to do is we have to eliminate these formulas. We have to bring these particular formulas in terms of and or. So let us do that. So P or R. So this is not P implies Q will become P or R, and so P implies Q biconditional P will become Q implies P and P implies Q. Again, we can factorize this in the next step, and what we can get is P or R and not Q or P and not P or Q. Now what we can observe is this is a three formula expression, three variable formula. So now here Q is missing, here R is missing, and here here PQ, yes, here R is missing and here also R is missing. So we can add them by disjuncting Q and not Q with that. So whenever we disjunct Q and not Q, we are not making any of the changes. So P or R same as it is, and it is disjuncted with Q and not Q. Q and not Q will be always false, and false and anything will be that anything. Again, here in the second expression there was no R, so I am adding R and not R. For the third expression, again there was no R, so I am adding not R. So solving this, what we get is we get PQR, P or Q or R, and P or not Q or R, and P or not Q or not R, not P or not Q or R, and not P or Q or R. So if you find any common terms here, you can eliminate that particular terms. So since we cannot find any common term, so this is the actual output. This is the principal conjunctive normal form for the given equation, this equation. Let us move ahead and let us try to solve some more example. So consider P is equal to not. Now this expression is find out principal conjunctive normal form for P is equal to not S. So S is given. S is given in the previous formula, that is this. Now it is not S. So apply not to this. Applying not to the complete formula. Now here you can see here not of S. So this not is to be applied. So PCNF for S is already we have identified, and these are the six terms they are there in the PCNF. Directly by seeing these terms, what you can do is you can directly whatever the terms they are not here. So there will be eight possible terms, and six are already here. Whatever the two terms are there, you can combine them by using the conjunction, and whatever the terms are there, that you can combine again by the disjunction, that I am going to show you in the next slide. But for now, so this is the given S, and I want to find it out for not S, PCNF for not S, that is conjunction of remaining max terms. Okay, so I should get the remaining two max terms. So here it will be PCNF of minus S will be, so whatever the two remaining max terms are there, that is, so there is, this is 111, then this is 101, wherever there is a not, that is to be considered as 0. This is 100, then this is 011, this is 010. So you can identify which are not there. I think here 000 is not there, then 001 is not there. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 terms over here. So 3 more terms are to be identified, and these are the 2. So 010 is there, 0110 is there, 100 is there, 101 is there, 110 is not there. So you can consider all that terms. So it will be not P or not Q or not R, that is here. So not P or not Q or not R, that is here. The second one is not P or not Q or R. So not P or not Q or R is here. And P, Q and not R. P, Q or not R. And these are all conjuncted together. Okay, so this is how we can find out the negation of a PCNF. So if you know the PCNF of a given formula, for its negation you have to identify the terms which are not there in this particular formula, and you can directly take them. Moving ahead, now my next question is what will be the principal conjunctive normal form for not of T. So this is a T is equal to not of S. Okay, now what will be the principal conjunctive normal form for not of T? This equation again. The same equation will be there. So it will be not T is equal to not S. T is equal to not S. That means not t is equal to not of not s. That means not t is equal to s. So you can directly take as it as s. Let us move ahead and let us try to solve the last example on principal distinctive normal form. So in the principal disjunctive normal form, find the, for a given table, find the principal disjunctive normal form and principal conjunctive normal form. So here, let us first know about principal disjunctive normal form. So in the truth table, the output, wherever it is true, that all terms will be considered as a mean terms and that can be taken. So the third one, then fifth one, sixth one and eighth one. So here the third one is true, false, true. That means it is, P is true means it is P and not Q, because Q is false, I am taking it as not Q, and R is true. So it will be P and Q and R. This is conjuncted. This is conjuncted with other formulas. One by one, go on taking it for all other. So pushed on. Sorry. Principal disjunctive normal form is P and not Q and R or the four terms. All these four terms. Okay. Similarly, we can identify the principal conjunctive normal form, and this will be the remaining four terms which are disjuncted together, and all these disjunctions are conjuncted together. So that is the difference. So you can see here, false, the output is false here, true, that is P or Q or R. So in this way you can take the principal conjunctive normal form. So that's all for this particular session. In the next session we are going to stick with the principal conjunctive normal form and principal disjunctive normal form, and we are going to discuss about the different representation of these normal forms. Thank you.